Hello, I'm Miles Kane. I'm back with Transmitter, and I'm in the record store in Islington, and I'm going to be picking my favourite records from the 50s right through to today. Well, the first record I'm going to pick today is from the 50s, and it's from a guy called Link Ray, and he was the first guy, the original guy, to do the Batman theme from those early Batman shows, and it was the first time I'd sort of heard that tremolo-y, reverb-y guitar, and the song The Rumble has been used in like a lot of films, and sort of like Tarantino uses a lot of his tracks in his films. Probably one of my favourite Beatles albums is A Hard Day's Night, and I think it's an underrated record, and I think maybe I got into it through watching the film, but I just love that got all these little songs on it that are about 2.5 minutes, but each one is just like a really good pop record, really. It's one of those records that when I first heard it, it sort of changed what you think about music and the way he used like lyrics and songs that I'd never heard before, and there were like these big sort of weird grand sort of changes in these songs, but they were still catchy. And it does remind me of that, of like being in school and hearing it for the first time, every time I hear it, you know. I discovered these properly, I guess. I'd heard Killer Moon and stuff like that, but when I joined my first band, The Little Flames, I discovered these, the first two records, Crocodiles and Heaven Up Here. And again, it was the Will Sargent, the guitarist, he sort of used that guitar sound that was similar to Link Ray in a way. But it was, I guess, adapted with these sort of dark pop songs, and a song like Show of Strength, and it had these sort of cool drum beats. And again, it was like the Link Ray guitar, sort of Bowie lyrics and these cool beats. It was like all those records I mentioned sort of in one band. And again, it just had a big influence on me. And it's a record I haven't heard for a while, but I remember it having a massive effect on me. There's so many bands I could have picked there, you know, Supergrass or Super Fairies or Pulp or The Verve, but we went for an Oasis one, and it's a single, and it's Roll With It. And again, I think it's just, it reminds me of that time again of being young as a kid, and first, you know, when you'd watch them on the telly and stuff, it sort of was like it blew your mind, really, and the attitude and the sort of style and the haircut. It was like nothing you'd seen before growing up, you know? This singer, who's now like, he's like 62, and this was his first record about 2 years ago, and he spent his whole life being a James Brown impersonator. And I think that they seen him in a club, you know, doing James Brown, and loved his voice, and then he got together with like the band, the Manhattan Street Band, which is this cool New York band. It's quite sort of soundtracky and sort of has those cool beats and brass and the twangy guitars. And they made a record with him, and this is his first one. And it's got that James Brown sort of feel to it, and it's soul-y, but when I just heard it, I just loved the sound of it. And the tune, The World Is Going Up in Flames, I think is amazing, and No Time For Dreaming. And it's just something that I can't stop listening to, really. So, yeah, it's worth checking out. I've been Miles Kane, and they've been my records, and I hope you like them.